environmental project manager responsible for the Southeast Market Pipelines Project, or SMP project, environmental review. With me tonight are Harry Jetty in the back, Commissioner Environmental Staff, Bill Braun, Nick Shields, and Monica Hagedick-Davis. On behalf of the five members of the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission, we would like to thank you for participating in tonight's public comment meeting on the draft environmental impact statement for the SMP project. I understand many of you would prefer that this meeting be held in either Hamilton or Suwannee counties. However, we were unable to locate facilities that we thought would adequately support the size audience we anticipated. As I will discuss later, the comment meetings are just one of three methods available to provide comments on the SMP project draft environmental impact statement. The purpose of tonight's meeting is for us, the commission staff, to receive comments from you, the public, on the draft environmental impact statement we prepared for the SMP project. The SMP project is actually three separate but connected natural gas transmission pipeline projects that would involve facilities in Alabama, Georgia, and Florida. The Transcontinental Gas Pipeline Company, Sable Trail Transmission, and the Florida Southeast Connection propose to construct and operate about 650 miles of natural gas pipeline, associated facilities, and six new compressor stations to transport up to 1.1 billion cubic feet of natural gas per day from Alabama to Florida. In Florida, Sable Trail and Florida Southeast Connection propose to construct and operate approximately 358 miles of pipeline across Hamilton, Suwannee, Gilchrist, Alachua, Levy, Marion, Sumter, Lake, Osceola, Citrus, Orange, Okeechobee, St. Lucie, and Martin counties. Additionally, Sable Trail proposes to construct three new natural gas compressor stations in Suwannee, Marion, and Osceola counties. Additional information about the S&P project and its components can be found on the FERC's website, www.ferc.gov. The FERC's e-library is the Commission's administrative record and contains copies of the three applications and all supplemental information provided. The e-library is also accessible from the FERC website. The e-library contains copies of our correspondence with other state and federal agencies, comments and letters submitted by affected landowners and concerned citizens, and our request to the applicants for additional environmental information. The National Environmental Policy Act requires the Commission to conduct an environmental review of all interstate natural gas transmission pipeline projects. The SMP draft EIS, which was issued on September 4, 2015, and sent to over 6,000 individuals and parties, was prepared in response to applications filed by the three companies in the fall of 2014. Commission staff worked for over 10 months to prepare this draft EIS. These 10 months are in addition to the years spent working in the pre-filing process. In total, almost 2 years have been spent on this environmental review. An environmental impact statement is an informational document. It is not a decisional document. A decision about this project has not been made. The EIS's purpose is to inform the Commission about the potential impacts on the human and natural environments that could result from construction and operation of the project. An environmental impact statement describes the environment as it exists today, the potential impacts on the environment, assesses and compares alternatives, and includes staff recommendations to avoid, minimize, and mitigate potential impacts. Specifically, the draft EIS includes an executive summary, an introduction which describes the purpose and need of the project, as well as the purpose and scope of the environmental review, descriptions of the proposed actions, including proposed facilities, land requirements, construction procedures, and environmental compliance monitoring. The environmental analysis contained in the draft environmental impact statement contains a review of geology, specifically karst, soils, water resources, groundwater, aquifers, wetlands, vegetation, wildlife, migratory birds, fisheries and aquatic resources, special status species, threatened and endangered species, land use and visual resources, socioeconomics, impacts on property values, cultural resources, air quality and noise, compressor station emissions, reliability and safety, pipeline integrity, safety standards and cumulative impacts, alternatives, and as I said before, includes our conclusions and recommendations, 14 appendices, maps, drawings, construction plans, and references. This draft EIS summarizes our comprehensive environmental view of the project and includes our conclusions and recommendations concerning the potential impacts of the project. As I said before, the Commission issued the draft EIS on September 4th, 2015. This began a 45-day comment period which closes on October 26th. In addition to the comments we will receive later this evening, I expect the Commission will receive numerous written and electronic comments. Comments received, whether they be verbal, written, or electronic, are treated the same. There is no preference given to one type of comment over the other. All comments received will be addressed in the final environmental impact statement. Comments may result in additional analysis and revisions to the EIS. As a reminder, comments can be provided verbally tonight, in written form, and submitted via U.S. mail to the Secretary of the Commission, or electronically via the FERC website, www.ferc.gov. For your convenience, we have also provided comment forms in the back that you may fill out and leave with us tonight. After receiving comments on the draft environmental impact statement, we will prepare a final environmental impact statement. Ultimately, the FERC commissioners will determine whether or not to approve the SMP project. This decision will be made after careful review of the applications, final environmental impact statement, and will consider all public comments submitted on the project. As stated in the meeting notice, issued along with the draft EIS, in order to make this meeting as fair and efficient as possible, we'll be enforcing a 3-minute time limit. Your minutes will start when you begin speaking. At 2 minutes and 30 seconds, the green light will change to yellow. At 2 minutes and 45 seconds, the yellow light will turn to red. And at 3 minutes, an alarm will sound. I recognize the choice each of you made tonight to be here, taking away time from your lives, your families, and your other responsibilities. Therefore, if you're still speaking when the alarm goes off, I'll allow you to finish your thoughts and conclude your comments. I believe time will allow this evening, so after everyone who has signed up to speak has spoken, I'll provide an opportunity for other speakers and an additional 3 minutes for folks that have already spoken. Your comments are being recorded and in the Commission's administrative record. If you would like a copy of tonight's meeting, you can speak to our reporter after the meeting, or you can download a copy once it's been placed in the Commission's record. Before we hear from our first speaker, will everyone please silence their cell phones? And when you come up to speak, please remember to spell your first and last names for the record. With that, we'll now call our first speaker. Number one, Mr. Joseph Hannerty,